So you happy?
I think so.
And I did good?
You did good.
So, am I forgiven?
Never.
You are a hard woman.
Ma! Pa! Come out here!
Sadie, you're alive! John, it's...
Sadie Adler.
Well, how'd you know she was...
I'm sorry, I
you
thought
look
I...
well. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Well, come on. But tell me about you, darling. All armed to the teeth like that.
I'm a working woman, Abigail. I'm a bounty hunter, bodyguard. I protect the gold prospectors up in the hills. I'm thinking of starting my own transportation business. I was thinking maybe if John wanted to earn some money.
My husband, he ain't looking for that kind of work.
I took on a lot of debt when we bought this place.
And you're working for her to pay it off?
Yes, sometimes I was.
But I thought we said no more of that.
No, you said that. What else am I gonna do? I'm a goddamn man.
It's legal work, Abigail. And I never got killed. It's hunting down fools for the government. Easy. Even Jack could do it.
Don't you put those stupid ideas in the boy's head. He's going to do something better than this.
Like what? Writing silly stories?
I'm sorry, Abigail. Really, I am. I just thought if you wanted to earn some money...
How many times do I gotta bury you, John Marston?
Never. You ain't never burying me. It's legal work that I can handle.
There's a... There's something else.
Micah?
Bounty hunting is one thing, but goddamn, Micah?
I heard he was upcountry, or some fellow who sounded just like him. Killed a family, bar a little girl who escaped.
Leave Micah alone.
Listen, I'm sorry, Abigail. I came by because I was riding by chasing a fella, and I thought John wanted to earn some extra money.
What is it?
Abigail, we need the money.
Some fella robbed his business. You know, an accountant or something. Came down from Rhodes, I believe.
How much does it pay?
It pays good. You know, the soft ones usually do.
Okay, then. I guess. But Micah? No.
All right. John Marston, let's go.
Just you bring him back to me. You hear?
Of course.
Come on, then.
Say your goodbyes, John. Get your horse and let's go. You ready? Follow me. We're going up into tall trees.
Hey, it's nice of you to stop by and see the place. Finally.
Abigail's back with the boy. You must be so pleased, John. And the ranch? You were right. It's really something.
I think I'm gonna ask her to, marry me. I got a ring. It was Arthur's. I found it in a bundle of things that I've kept.
You're marrying Abigail. Or asking her, at least. Oh, my. I never took you for a romantic.
No, me neither. But it's something I've thought about. And I think I know I want it.
Okay. I guess I thought you were married already. Long ago.
No. Not really. Not officially.
Well, I'm real happy for you, Joan. Being married, it made me real happy. We're cutting off the main track up here by Manzanita Post. Ha! So, we're coming up on where he's been seen. This moron accountant Marshall Thurwell been trying to live like an outdoorsman? Camping out here.
He's lucky the Skinner brothers ain't found him.
Well, they might have. Up here. Easy. Must be it. Get down. Let's take a look around. Something's been here. This looks...
Looks like a bear or something came through here.
Fella left in quite a hurry. Here. Oh, he was from the south, whoever he is.
Then maybe he's our man. If he ain't become some bear's lunch.
Yeah, looks like they went this way.
Him or the bear?
Both of them. It's that way, I'd say.
Great.
Damn it! I lost the trail. Can you see which way he might have gone?
Okay, I think I got him. Follow me. Keeps going through here. There's a cabin up here. Yeah, this way.
Pretty.
Oh boy, that our fella?
Maybe, but looks more like a local farmer to me. Or what's left of one.
Is he gone?
You Marshall Thurwell?
That I am, ma'am.
I'm here to arrest you on behalf of the state of Lemoyne. You're wanted for theft, fraud, and avoiding arrest.
Is the monster still out there?
No, I think he's gone.
Come out!
Come on.
Don't shoot.
Keep walking. Come on.
I'm coming. Look out!
I can't believe we didn't kill that bastard.
Gave him something to remember us by, at least. You all right, John?
Yeah. We always find a way to almost get killed, don't we?
Mm-hmm. That's kind of the problem. Maybe it wasn't right of me to bring you along on those really heavy things. A family man and all. Seeing all this, I don't know if I can do it again.
I'm my own man, ain't I? I get to make those calls. I needed the money.
You are your own man, sure. But I'm my own woman. And I get to say who I ride with. And I don't know if your ranch and your kid and your wife are things I want to be worrying about when I hear a gunshot.
Yeah, fair enough. Those are fine new clothes, by the way.
Yeah? Who's this up here?
Is that... Are you Sadie Adler, ma'am? The bounty hunter?
Get off the road!
Look, I got great respect for you professionally, but if that's Marshall Thurwell there, me and my partner would like to split the reward.
You're doing what? Get off the road!
We was thinking you might need protection.
I look like I need protection?
Me and my partner, we're dead set on splitting that reward. And if not, well, we said we was gonna have to take all of it. Get her!
It does require a certain level of detachment.
You ever think if it's right?
No. I just see orders on the wall, and I try and fill them. And if there's other bastards after the same orders as I am, I get competitive. It's called industry. And if you ain't noticed, everyone is out there doing it.
I guess they are. You said earlier you knew something about Micah. You gonna tell me what you know?
Are you sure you want to hear about him? Ain't all that back at your ranch enough? If I find him, I will handle it.
Your bounties or transport work? That's your decision to bring me along or not. But Micah? That's something I gotta do, with or without you, Sadie. You know what I mean?
Okay, I know. Well, I'm hearing things. A lot of things. Still, mostly just whispers, but I think you might be pretty close.
When you hear something real, you bring it to me.
Here, put them down. Go on. Get home to your wife. I'll let you know if I hear anything about Micah.
You need a hand taking him in?
Him? No, I'm fine.
You sure?
Yeah, I'll send your share to the bank when I get paid.
Thank you. Hey, mister.
Can you believe that? I'm looking for my friend, Gavin. For Gavin.
Has he been gone long?
Yeah. A few years. A few bloody years. I can't remember what he looks like. I'm looking for him, but I don't know who he is.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah. Me too. I wasted my life. Looking. I looked, but I never saw.
I can't believe my
eyes. I saw nothing. in the head.
Good luck.
Kevin!
I am so worried.
Hey there, glad you stopped in.
Gav! Gav!
Sure, you can look, but don't try me.
Gav! Where are you? Where are you? Hide nor hair of him.
Ain't it time for you to leave yet, or?
Oh, that's really. Gavin!
What are you waiting for, then?
Where are you?
Howdy there, you doing?
Nice.
Not today, ain't it?
I just hope it holds out.
This is really worrying me.
Move it!
Mister!
Out of the way!
Hey.
Sir!
How do you do, sir?
I'll only shut up once I can vote.
John! John Marston.
Miss Tilly.
That's Mrs. Tilly to you. How are you?
I'm okay. How are you? Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm well. Well and happy, and I miss you and Abigail.
She's well. Jack's well. All is well, I think. I never thanked you for what you did.
Oh, there's the trolley. I still think about all of you all the time. My life, it's different now.
Mine too. But I still see a bunch of Charles and Uncle and Sadie. So not quite so different as Abigail would like.
I married a lawyer. He's a fine man. We live in a house.
Us too.
I'm sorry, I've gotta go. I'm late, but can I write to you and Abigail someplace?
Yeah, we're up at Beecher's Hope. Over in Great Plains, West Elizabeth.
I'll try. Be well, John Marston.
Okay, Missy. ma'am.
Hello, sir.
Ma'am, it's not often I come across.
So, you found me.
Hey, what are you doing?
Stay back for your own sake. I walk with the undead.
What, you're a vampire?
I have been called many names over the centuries. Now go. Or I'll feed on you, too.
Yeah, you're no more a vampire than I am.
I'll suck you dry.
You ain't much of a fucker.
I cannot be killed.
Thank you. Who are you?
Found this old letter. The mayor sent it to a friend of mine, Mr. Kilgore. I'm here seeing if I can be of any help.
All right. Wait here. Follow me.
Hello.
John Marston.
Education is the most wonderful thing. It'll raise us higher and higher. Make civics and ethics less a work of dirty-minded pragmatists like me. And the calling of higher, better men.
Hear, hear.
Without it, we are savages. But with learning, why, in 50 years, man will put down his guns and start living a life of relentless purity.
Hear, hear.
But the rich can be so very self-absorbed.
How can I help?
You can't.
We need all our strengths. That's the point. We've gone over this.
Violence is never right.
I agree with you. But it's not violence. It's the mere threat of violence.
Against whom?
Oh. Against Hector Fellow's worst nature. To convince him to make good on his promise to help finance the library.
Who is he and where do I find him?
He's a newspaper man. Oh. And he's...
He's leaving town on a coach, heading to his country estate because he doesn't like your heavy-handed approach.
And he's gonna really hate my heavy-handed approach.
Thank you, Mr. Marston.
You'll spot him on the road through the bayou. He has a red coach. So we are clear. I do not approve of this behavior.
Okay. Get your hands up.
Who the heck are you?
Hold it right there. You're getting an extra passenger. Okay, drive.
What the hell do you want?
Mr. Fellows, ain't it? Charity, sir. An appeal to your better nature.
This is most impudent.
Oh, no. This is not most impudent. Trust me, buddy. I can be a whole lot more impudent than this. But this is for a great cause. And for a wealthy man such as yourself, A chance to add some dignity to all that wealth.
Dignity?
To help finance a library in town. Just think of the prestige.
Oh, get out of my carriage!
But the mayor...
Mayor? The mayor is a crook.
Me too. And I'm a real crook.
I will not be bullied by you, sir. Get out of here!
Sorry? Was that... Yes! I would like to finance the library for the common good! I can't hear you! What was that?
Please! All right!
There. See? That wasn't difficult. You know, they say... It's better to give than to receive, and certainly in the case of a beating, I know that to be true. The mayor awaits your check, sir. Been a pleasure. There's a good man in there. You should let him live a little more. Driver! Hold up! As you were, move on!
It's you. Come in.
What's his name?
Jean-Marc, he's a little histrionic. I'm worried that he's going to open his mouth and say things that aren't true to those vulgar Puritans at the newspaper. Well, perhaps true, but not the whole truth. Look at these beautiful books. This is magnificent. We'll bring this city back to life if it kills me, and it probably shall.
Yeah?
I have two copies of this book. This is an old field guide. Might be of some interest to you, maybe not. But please have it. It's worth quite a bit.
Thank you.
My pleasure. Listen, Mr. Marston, I'm sorry to ask this of you. You've done so much, but...
Go on.
Jean-Marc. I'm afraid he's going to open his mouth and say things.
How do you mean?
Saying nasty things about the work that we have done together, for example.
Is that my business?
Oh, no. No. Of course not. He also found out some unsettling news about you. It's all scurrilous lies, of course. But...
What sort of news?
Oh, I do not talk about idle gossip. Please, I'm a public servant, and we are friends.
Where do I find him?
Well, he does live over on Rue de Zachary. Thank you, Mr. Marston.
Come on, lady. Thank you. Why you want to say those awful things about me, buddy? Best not make a drama of things. Come on, let's see your boss. This is gonna hurt, but it's for the best.
Quick, Miss Marston. Bring him around the back.
Remember, sir, I am the mayor.
Oh, Jean-Marc, I've missed you. I've missed you. What silly, silly man we have been.
Here. My brother, Jean-Marc. Well, we've been so... I promised to change.
I know.
What a silly, silly misunderstanding. You see, the problem is principles will destroy us all.
Sure. As long as you two are friends again.
Yes. And you say you've changed, so we will run the city like men of honor, like you said.
Of course. We will strive to improve the city's moral backbone by any means available to us.
Within reason, yes.
Yes. Within my reason. Because I'm the mayor, Jean-Marc. And I will save you from yourself. Because it's better to get something done than nothing at all, like you said.
Utterly corrupted, Lemieux. You've not changed at all. I've been supplanted in your esteem by a wanted murderer. You shame me.
No, sir. You shame me with your vain naivete. Oh, how I long for the luxury to have principles such as you. But I must actually do things.
I see now. You're lost to reason.
Yeah. And I see now that you're a horrible little wretch and a sinner yourself. Your sin is deluded vanity. Now, sir, I am afraid that you must kill him. I will pay you handsomely. And Jean-Marc, I will miss you. I really shall.
Kill him.
It must be so. Please.
You're not really going to kill me, are you?
Thought I might.
But all I did was love too much.
Love.
My duty.
But you're running your mouth.
I'll leave you out of it.
Friends and him.
He'll betray you just like he's betrayed me. Lemieux is a foul rat, but I'm a man of my word. Let me live and I'll destroy him. And I'll make sure you're left well alone. Come on. Please, come on. You want to shoot a sad little man, would you?
I might be a brute, but I'm not a paid killer. Get out of here and don't mention me, boy.
I give you my word.